how many times have you heard someone say it never hurts to ask? I'm going to tell you, sometimes it hurts to ask. But this time it didn't. What this is the AGA TD. Let's see, where's the little etched UD logo on it. This is the AGA TD. It comes from my vapor store, and it was sent to me free. Why? For review purposes? No. I am Steve Perry from SmokingTheBandwidth.com, and I am slaving over this very hot atomizer to bring you the best electronic cigarette news, views, and reviews available on the World Wide Web. And I got this free from my vapor store because I asked. I do a heck of a lot of business with these guys. I buy a lot of cartomizers, a lot of batteries, heads for the iClear 30 and 16. I just got the Kanger Pro tanks, and I had recently, maybe a couple months ago, purchased the AGA T Plus from my vapor store. And then the AGA TD comes out. It's dual coil. So I just sent him a little message and said, hey, you know, I do a lot of business with you guys. Would you mind throwing one of these in on my order? I don't want to have to pay. I had found a backdoor way to dual coil the AGA T Plus, so I didn't want to have to pay for this, but this would make my life so much easier. And they just, boom, dropped it in the box. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how I build it with silica wicks, because if you look in there, I don't know if you can see or not, but I like dual wicks because it's at night and that flash is getting in the way. I like two wicks, so basically what I do, well, you're about to see, it's one wick, of course, folded over. We build the coil. We pull the wick up through the lid, up through the coil, and bam, we're ready to go. I'm just going to give you a quick rundown on that, and then we're going to come back and we're going to look at how this thing vapes. All right, so here we're going to wick and coil the AGA TD, and what you want to do is, there's your post and there's the bottom. I'm using silica and not stainless steel mesh. So what you're going to want to do is take this up to the top of the post and bend it over. And that's basically going to be the length that you're going to want for your silica wick, because for this build we are going to double up on the, this is 3 millimeter silica, and we are going to double the wick. So there's one wick, and then for the other one, of course, you can use the one that you just kind of eyeballed. And give it a clip, and there's your wicks. Now, for the coil, I'm gonna do, let's do 4 wraps. This should give us 0.8 ohm. And I'm just gonna wrap it around this screw here to build a nice coil. Now, and through the coil. Of course, now on this build, this is 3 millimeter wick, and we're gonna double it over, so it's gonna be a little difficult to get through the top, and it helps to just wet your fingers. And of course you don't want to drench it or anything, but just kind of wet the wick, and it'll slide through that, through the holes in here is not a real problem. But once you get let's see if you can see that, there you go. We're gonna go up through the bottom like this and then just pull it through. But once you get up to the coil is gonna be a rather tight fit. So you're going to look here, this is your shorter lead to the outside. Boy, this is a pain to do on camera. You're just going to run that through the coil. Bring it down. And pull the wick up through the coil without pulling the wick up through the bottom, or you're gonna have to start all over. see if I got that on camera. My fingers are blocking it. But there you can see, and I got the hook still through it, but you can see how we got the wick around the coil, and then we just slide that out. And there's your first coil. Alright, we're back. It's built. We're going to vape it. The liquid we got in there is a 30 PG 70 VG. So this is a rather thick liquid. It should give us great vapor production. It's no surprise. Of course, I've used it before. Just recently, though, I've avoided this e-liquid and because it has banana in it. Not big on banana, but it's just a hint. And this is a wonderful e-liquid. This is Candied Cavendish from the Plume Room. And this is our 0.8 ohm dual coil build on the AGA TD. And there is nothing here to complain about. The flavor on this is excellent. And of course, a lot of you like your stainless steel mesh wicks. Knock yourself out. I tried it for a while. Just not a fan. I know they say it gives you a purer flavor, but I'm used to the flavor I get with the silica wicks, and I frankly like it. As you can see, the vapor production on this thing is excellent. The tank, a little small. I think it holds 2 milliliters, but you know, you're gonna have to refill it. I put the screw back in so that it doesn't leak if I happen to. I don't set it on its side. I basically have a setup in my truck where it'll sit just about like that, and I set it like that. I get very minimal leak. You might get a little come out one of the air holes. And that's another beauty on this. And by the way, if you go to smokingabandwidth.com, try saying that 3 times fast, I've got pictures up, and I'll show you on the pictures how these air holes in the cap, you can see one there and one there, and they line up with air holes on the rim inside the device. So basically, what you're doing is you're lining that air hole up with one on the rim, and that's how your air is feeding in right at the bottom level, and it just gives a beautiful draw, excellent vapor production from the AGA TD dual coil atomizer. I love this thing. I got nothing bad to say about it. I know what some people are going to say about it as a negative is the air holes. Basically, now if you want to drill it out, you're going to have to drill the hole in the cap and then drill the hole down here, or else you're going to have to drill an entirely new hole in the cap. So it's, you know, twice the work for those that like to drill them out. But with the two different sizes, it does give you, the small hole is a little too tight for me, but I don't like a really airy draw, so the other hole, the larger hole on the side, is perfect for me. And it just creates excellent vapor, excellent flavor, a really smooth hit, a nice draw, not too tight, not too loose. I'm loving the AGA TD, and I am going to be using the heck out of this thing. Thank you, my vapor store. Check out all my reviews, and the pictures for this review will also show you, if you didn't go through the whole video, it'll show you how to put this device together in the pictures over at smokingabandwidth.com. One more drag off of this, and we're out.